teacher Naya, and I work at the Harlan County Boys and Girls Club, and I'm excited to start the Start Smart program with you all at your school. It's a program that will give you a firm foundation to make smart choices throughout your life about drugs and alcohol and just other situations that will arise in your future. This is to prepare you to be able to have the confidence, the assertiveness, and the knowledge, most of all, to be able to make smart choices about those situations, because knowledge is power. And without the knowledge, you may or may not know how to act in those situations. You may not understand the wrong choice from the smart choice, which would be the correct choice. So my goal for you all throughout this program is to give you all knowledge and power and confidence to know what to do no matter what situation you are in. The first thing that I need you all to do is I need you all to do your pretest, which is where I just want you all to be open and honest and try to do the best that you can in answering those questions. You may not understand some of those questions. You may not have the knowledge right now that you need to correctly answer those questions, and that's okay. I don't want you to get upset if you don't answer anything right, if you don't know the answer, if you don't know what a word means, because we're going to keep talking about that stuff throughout this program. And the goal is that by the time you take your post-test, that you will understand all of that and you will have made progress and you will have done better on the post-test than you did the pre-test, because on the pre-test you might not have understood, you might have the knowledge to make the correct answers, but by the time the post-test comes around, you're going to remember the things we've talked about, you're going to gain knowledge, you're going to have a better understanding of what you need to do. So that is my goal for you all. So first thing, if you haven't already, take your Start Smart pre-test. It's just you're going to tell me a little bit about yourself, your name, your last name. You're going to do some true or false questions. Then you're going to have a couple multiple choice questions. And then you're going to go into the survey where you're going to strongly agree, disagree, strongly disagree, and you're just going to answer those to the best of your ability, and that's the way we're going to get the program started. So I would encourage you all, if you haven't already taken that, to do so, and if you have already, thank you for doing that. And I'm going to go ahead and start into a couple of our first lessons for you all today. Our first lesson that we like to talk about is our community. Your community is where you live. So I kind of live in Wallens. I live in Tremont. That's my community. When I'm at work, the Boys and Girls Club is a part of my community. Everyone that works here with me is a part of my community. Harlan Independent School is a part of my community. If you live in Black Mountain, your part of your community might be the school there. You will have different people in your community. Your community is basically where you reside, the people, the businesses, and the places in the homes that make up your community. Everybody's community is going to look different. Everybody's community is going to consist of different people, and that is okay, but I just want you to start thinking about what your community is, what is important in your community to you. An important part of my community for me is the Boys and Girls Club and all of the kids who come here. When I'm able to go out into the schools and teach this program, all of the students at the schools become a part of my community, and I think that's really great. We all have different communities and different areas. We all have different talents and gifts and things that we can use in our communities to help our communities be a better place. We all can be agents of change in our community to make things better. You can even make things better in your home. You can make things better in your community. You can make things better wherever you go. You can help people to make smart choices, right choices, the correct choices. You can stand up and do a lot of things. I want you all to start thinking about what areas in your community offer you safe places to go to. What are the unsafe places in your neighborhoods that you do not need to go to? Unsafe places that you may not need to go to are places where you know people do drugs, where you know people drink at. Those would be unsafe places for you, because if you go to those areas, those are putting you at risk to partake in risky behavior. That is going to put you in a place where you may be asked to do those things. You may be a around those things. And the goal is for you all to not have to be around those places. So to get you to not go to those places, I need to get you to understand that there are a lot of safe places for you to go. The Boys and Girls Club is a very safe place for you to go that is in your community, where we have a lot of fun every single day. We learn, we grow. We enjoy, we laugh, we smile. We do a lot of fun things here at the club. This is a fun place for you to go if you don't have anywhere else to go. This can be your safe place. Other safe places in your community may be your church. A church would be a safe place for you to go. Your school system should be a safe place for you to go. And everybody's school is going to be different, but your school is a safe place for you because at that school, you have teachers, you have principals, you have guidance counselors, you have people that who love you and care for you and want to help you make the best decisions, who are trying to raise you up to be the best that you can be. And that should be a safe place. I think of, I'm at the Boys and Girls Club right now, obviously. So I think of the Harlan County Library. That's a really good safe place for you to go. You can read books there. You can use the internet there to help you with school. That's a really safe place for you to go as well. What are the safe places in your community? Sometimes your own house may not be a safe place, but do you have another safe place to go? Maybe that's grandma or grandpa's house. Maybe that's aunt or uncle's house. Maybe that's a special person's house. Wherever you need to go, that needs to be your safe place, because everybody deserves to have a safe place where they feel safe, where they feel secure, where they feel cared for, and where they do not have to be around drugs and alcohol and other things that could put them at risk, that could put you in danger. So that is our first lesson, is about your community. What in your community is the safe and the unsafe places? I can't be with you right now. If I were with you, we would write this down. We would write the list of unsafe places, and that would kind of be our map of our community to teach us where to go. So because I'm not there with you, maybe just think about that in your head and mentally just make that checklist of the safe places and the not so safe places that you do not need to go, and stay away from the unsafe places. Pass right by the unsafe places. Maybe you need to take a different route home so you don't go by people who are doing drugs. You don't go by that house where alcohol's at. Maybe that needs to be something mentally that you just need to start doing. But whatever you need to do, go ahead and just start thinking about that, and think about how you don't have to be around the unsafe places, and then start focusing on the safe places, the places that you can go, the places where you can be safe, the places where you can be loved, the places where you can be encouraged, the places where you can be built up and not tore down, and kind of go towards those places instead of the unsafe places in your community. You can also, going right into that, you can make the right choices in your community to do these things. You may feel like you are too young. You may feel like you're too little. You may feel like no one listens to you. But we all have a voice. We all have the power and the responsibility to change our lives. It is okay for us to say no to people. It is okay for us to say no to friends who are trying to take us to unsafe places. Because if your friend is trying to put you in danger, if your friend is asking you to do drugs or alcohol, first of all, they are not your friend. So it is okay to say no to them. It is okay to not be around them. It is okay not to even go to their house. If you're going to your friend's house and that's in your community, but they are asking you to do things that go against what you need to be doing to stay drug and alcohol free, then you don't need to go there, because your friend's house is an unsafe place. And so you have to have the control over yourself to make the right and the correct choice, the smart choice to not go there, to not partake in those things. Sometimes the smart choice is telling your parents, telling your special person, telling someone at school, hey, this is going on. So-and-so is asking me to do drugs. So-and-so is asking me about alcohol. That is a way that you can make a smart choice in your community to also create a safe place. Because it takes all of us working together. It takes all of us standing up. It takes all of us using our voices so that we create safe places for everyone. Because I use my voice, I use my knowledge, I use my responsibility at the Boys and Girls Club to create a safe place here. I do the same thing when I'm at home with my own children and my own sons. I do everything there in my power to make a safe place for them. We all can make a safe place. We all can make correct choices. We all have the okay to say no when negative things try to come in our lives, when people try to be that negative influence on our life. We need to focus on being around positive influences. What are positive influences in your community? Positive influences are people and places who encourage you to be the best that you can be, who not only encourage you, but they're also leading you and helping you to be the best that you can be. Those are the people, those are the places that you need to gravitate towards. That's where you need to be. You do not need to be around anyone who is telling you that drugs and alcohol are the way to go. You do not be around anyone who's telling you that you're never going to grow up and amount to anything. You do not need to be around negative influences who are putting you at risk for harmful behaviors. You need to get away from those people and those places and instead start building yourself a community with good voices, with positive voices, with good places, with safe places to be. And it's up to you all to do that because you have the power to do that. And so that's our first couple of lessons. And I'm excited to start more lessons with you all and more videos. And until then, bye everybody.